I'm Frederick Lauren, and I've rented the house on Haunted Hill tonight so that my wife can give a party. A haunted house party. She's so amusing. There'll be food and drink and ghosts, and perhaps even a few murders. To typist, and from drunk to jet high, they share one thing, they all need money. Now let's see if they're brave enough to pay.
And you call this a party? Why do you always do that? It spoils the champagne.
It might explode.
Never done.
Would you guarantee that?
That isn't funny, Frederick.
Make a good headline, Playboy kills wife with champagne. Join me?
No, thank you.
Just a sip. Might improve your humor.
My humor is fine, thanks. And I haven't poisoned it.
It's always good to know that. Have some. You'll enjoy the party more.
And then, carried away by hysteria, took a swing at him and simply went on from there.
But well, she certainly went on. How many people did she kill?
Only two. Her husband and her sister. No one else was here.
So there are two loose heads just floating around in here somewhere?
You can hear them at night. They whisper to each other.
Good evening. I'm your host, Frederick Lauren. We're all strangers to each other. Let's get
Lawrence, I advise you to call this party off now. The ghosts are already moving and that's a bad sign.
Let me apologize for my wife. She'll join us later. What can that? Now, before the party begins, let's go over the details. The caretakers will leave at midnight, locking us in here until they come back in the morning. Once the door is locked, no way out. The jail, and the only door to the outside locked like a vault. No electricity, no clock, no one within miles. So, let it call for help,
like a coffin.
So, if any of you decide not to stay in the party, please let me know before midnight. Of course, if you leave, I shan't be able to pay you anything.
I'm interested in your reason.
I think everyone wonders what they would do if they saw her. But now my wife has given us all the opportunity to find
her. Music, ghosts, etc., being only creations of hysteria, your party should be a success.
But you care promises is genuine, though.
Seven, maybe more, little money. Four men have been murdered in this house. And three women.
Good for everyone.
Richard, why don't you take us on a tour through the house?
Who didn't die here, he was electrocuted later.
Mr. Norton did a good deal of experimenting with wives, but his wife didn't think it was any good.
So he filled a bath with acid, threw her in. She was supposed to stay down, but the bones came. It's a funny thing, but none of the murders here were just ordinary. Just shooting, stabbing. God, she didn't fall in.
You mean there's still acid in there?
Everything with hair and flesh. Just leaves the bones. My, it's dry and dusty down here.
Oh, there's
a cure for that big. Come on.
Lance is gone. Gone where? And the only way you could pump your head in here, to run head on into the wall. You didn't do that, did you? Let's get a bandage on it.
Nora, when you came in, you said something about a ghost.
There was one.
What did it look like?
Well, it was wearing a black thing that went all the way to the floor.
Weren't you a little frightened at the time?
Well, yes.
That, Mr. Lauren, is hysteria.
But then, Doctor, how do you explain what happened to Max? Was that hysteria, too?
You better get that checked in a day, sir.
Thanks, Doc.
The ghosts are coming closer, Mr. Lauren.
You really believe in your pet ghost, don't you, Pritchard?
Before the night's over, you will, too.
Would you like a drink, lad?
No, thanks.
I'd like one. God's hand.
Someone or something was in here when I came in. But where? And if the door was locked, how did it get out?
What you saw might have been a ghost, Nora. What was in here with me was no ghost.
I don't know. I was so scared.
Chandelier and the private bashes here.
Is he badly hurt?
He's had
selling, you do most of it in your fashion.
Yes,
I lie awake nights wanting my marriage. Was rather a mistake.
You didn't have any idea how this would choose, but I think it was a mistake.
It's almost time to lock up the house. Then your party will really begin. I wonder how it'll end. If any of you don't survive, $50,000 will be divided amongst the rest of you. If I should die, you will be paid by my estate. When the door is locked from the outside by the caretakers, we'll all be forced to stay in this house until morning. If any of you decide not to stay, you must leave with the caretakers now. You won't have a chance to change your minds later, because there'll be nobody to get out.
I don't want to
die. Wait. Rather dangerous. I suppose you all know how to use one of these things, but in case you don't, you just press down on this lever with your thumb and then pull the trigger. You see, they're loaded.
These are no good against the dead, only the living.
Doctor? Perhaps. Nora, go ahead and take it. Miss Bridget. And here's yours, dear.
Don't need it.
It was your idea. Who knows, you may want to use it on me before this night is over.
Throw these guns away. They won't do you any good.
I agree with Richard on that point, although not for the same reason.
Dr. Trent, don't you approve of our little party favorites?
Suppose Nora had had a gun when she mistook the blind woman for a ghost.
I don't think anyone else is going to walk around in total darkness. Oh, I'm sure we're not going to go running around the house shooting each other, aren't you?
Who knows? Fear makes people do amazing things.
Darling, I really don't need this.
The show starts in 10 minutes.
Yum, yum. It's time for a tasty and refreshing snack. Promise to satisfy your hunger, your thirst, your sweet tooth. So visit our refreshment center now. Let's go!
The show starts in 9 minutes.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat. The sparkling drinks are just dandy. The chocolate bars and the candy. So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Show starts in 8 minutes.
Today we're interviewing a stomach.
Hello there.
What is life like as a stomach?
Oh, boy, it was humdrum. I mean, until what's-his-name discovered Tony's Pizza.
Tony's Pizza?
Yeah, I was suffering from the pizza cravings until Tony's came along. Crispy crust and zesty sauces. Wow.
And so now... What's that?
Another pizza craving. Just thinking about Tony's sets it off.
Oh, well, where are you going?
He's going to get a Tony's pizza. And I follow him anyway.
Does your stomach send you pizza craving signals? Tony's, the pizza craver's pizza. Available at the concession stand.
There's plenty of time to treat yourself to something good to eat at
at our refreshment center.
The show starts in 7 minutes.
Monsters do have their place in the zoo, in your nightmares, in the deep, in your favorite horror movies. But not in your living room, on your TV. Don't let pay TV be the monster in your living room. Pay TV and cable TV companies are seeking the right to charge you for the very programs you now get free. If you want to stop pay TV and save free television, sign the petition in the lobby of this theater. Let your lawmakers know how you feel in the fight against pay TV and cable TV.
The show starts in 6 minutes.
It's intermission. Rise and stretch time. Time to refresh yourself and visit our snack bar. The juicy Frank sizzling hot. Showtime will be announced loud and clear to get you back to your car in time. So stretch your legs. Come to the snack bar now.
Hello. You hungry? Looking for a tempting treat? Hold on till I absorb some heat. Some added time might please you too. I'll slide into an oven fresh bun, and I'm ready for your eating fun.
Why don't you try a juicy good hot dog? Mmm, delicious.
Show starts in 5 minutes. Show starts in 4 minutes.
Hot dogs with your favorite trimming for men and boys, girls and women. Dress them up to suit your taste. They're good. So good.
You are invited to join the banshees, the werewolves, the vampires, the gooks, who are all coming to our Halloween convention of spooks. You'll enjoy this lively group if your blood doesn't end up in the soup. Practice your screams. Break out your shrouds. Tighten your nerves. And join the crowds at our convention of spooks.
Show starts in 3 minutes.
With mustard and relish, you guarantee mouth-watering satisfaction. And our ship's his costume on a beautiful golden bun. There's his cue to go out on stage.
He's the natural.
He's the rage. Meet this personality at our refreshment counter. Treat the family.
Class, come to order, pay attention just once. We have a lesson to teach you to dance.
Is the candy good conviction?
Now the baking is perfection.
Have we got a good selection?
We invite your co-dissection.
Is the ice cream not delicious? Help us take the fun, no delicious. Is the popcorn crisp and elder?
Now it is sure a mouthful.
Is the soda cold and fizzy?
My
keep the bubbles busy.
Not just good to listen is learned, a trip to the sweet bar you have earned. Now is time for intermission. Feed yourself to self-nutrition.
The show starts in 2 minutes.
Here's the way we quench our thirst, quench our thirst, quench our thirst. Here's the way we quench our thirst. At the refreshment counter, now's the time to yum, yum, yum. Yum, 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 yum. Now's the time to yum, yum, yum. At the refreshment counter, popcorn, drinks, and candy too. Candy too, candy too. Popcorn, drinks, and candy too. At the refreshment counter, at the refreshment counter, at the refreshment counter.
The show starts in 1 minute.
It's refreshment time, folks. Time out for a delicious snack in our sparkling refreshment building. Every item a fresh, appetizing taste treat.
We've a large assortment of freshly made sandwiches. How about a pizza? None better anywhere. Sizzling hamburgers grilled to your taste. Mouth-watering chili dillies. Crispy hot fresh French fries.
Yum, yum. It's a meal in itself. Our all-meat super dough. Enjoy one now.
The management of this theater thanks you for your patronage.
I'm sure you've come to the same conclusion I have.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, let's all have a meeting and discuss what to do. The living room?
Okay, in a minute. I gotta go downstairs. Now you lock yourself in here and don't let anybody know you're here. If you're dead, he won't come here, and I'll get back as soon as I can. If you have to, you use it.
Thank you.
what's her name?
Nora.
I didn't disturb her since I don't think this concerns her.
No, you're right.
Mr. Locke, isn't there some way we can get out of this house now?
None at all.
We could try breaking out.
The only door to the outside is made of steel. The bars of the windows are set in solid stone. You gotta stay.
I'm not afraid of your ghost, Bridget.
But I am afraid.
When we came here a few hours ago, the only thing we had in common was the $10,000 we shared. Now, however, we share something else. Step of the slot. So far tonight, one of us was almost killed by a falling chandelier. One of us was mysteriously slugged. One of us has been driven to the brink of absolute hysteria, and one of us is dead. Were these accidents? Suicides? And we must stay here for 6 more hours.
6 hours? 5 minutes.
You'll be next.
Let me ask you a question, darling. You were the first one to see my wife here. Did you also see anything that she could have climbed up on and then jumped?
No.
Did any of you? There was nothing. How then did she get up there?
Exactly, Mr. Lauren. How? She couldn't have pulled herself up there. She couldn't have dropped from the ceiling. Do you think your wife killed herself?
No. She was murdered by one of you.
Or you, Mr. Lauren. Deliberately kill someone, you must have a reason.
We were all strangers to your wife. Only you had a motive for murder. What husband had sometime wanted to kill his wife? What husband hasn't had a thousand opportunities to do it in such a way so that he'd never be suspected? I'm not such a fool as to hang my wife from the ceiling by a rope.
The fact remains that you, or one of us, murdered Mrs. Lawrence. That's a matter for the police.
So how do we get the police?
That's my point. We can't until morning. What began as a silly party given by an eccentric has now involved us all in murder.
Once Pritchard may be right. If another murder's in the works, let's stop it now.
Another murder?
Why not? Maybe one of us saw.
Why should even a millionaire want to give each of us $10,000 to spend one night in a gloomy old house? See some ghosts? Have a party? No.
Finish trying me, Doctor. Is the verdict guilty of murder?
Oh, this isn't getting us anywhere. Somebody killed Mrs. Lauren. We know that.
All we have for the next 6 hours is protect us from each other.
Really think?
I don't think anything. I just know that I'm going to my room. And if anybody comes in, I'll shoot him. Or her.
And if we all stay in our room, we'll be safe. Because the innocent will have no reason to leave his room. And the guilty will admit his guilt if he or she.
And we all have guns. We're all agreed.
I wish this night were over.
Nora, it's me, Vance.
Okay. They've all gone to their rooms and locked themselves in.
Vance, I've been thinking. It was so dark down there. Maybe it wasn't Mr. Lawrence.
Him, all right. He tried to kill you, and he did kill his wife.
How can you be so sure?
She tried to warn me, asked me to help him. The doc thinks he's going to try and kill one of us. Now, there must be a way out of this place, and I'm going to find him and get the police before he does.
I'm going with you.
What if he finds out you're alive? No, Nora, you're safer here than any place else. Now, just lock yourself in and keep quiet. admission of guilt, Doctor?
Certainly not. There's either somebody else in this house or one of us has left his room. Did you hear anything?
Organ music.
That. And someone walking.
I got you. Ready?
You look downstairs, and I'll look up here.
Why not together?
There may be only minutes, seconds left of someone's life. Why waste time? It's almost over, darling. Every detail was perfect. Accidentally shoot somebody? Who would suspect that we'd planned it that way that we drove it?
Not
by
suicide.
Just a constant part of the game. We claimed it was a dummy since I've touched it.
We had it.
Well, they had no idea what they were really doing.
What about Nora? She's not stupid.
Darling, believe me, everything we planned is working for her. Nora is sure Frederick murdered you. She thinks Frederick attacked her in the cellar, not me. But now Nora's almost out of her mind with fear. Heads, the music, you're hanging. I tell you, when Frederick falls in there, she'll shoot him.
Taking too long. David, you ought to be there.
More, many more. Yeah, so clearly I'm a little crazy. Thank you everybody for coming. I know some people are coming from way out of the way. I have one more tune left for you, and I can actually call it a song, unlike pretty much everything else in my program. So I'm gonna call it a song. Unbeknownst to probably some of the people in the crowd, the majority of my degree has not been spent exclusively on trumpet. Not that it hasn't been my primary focus, but I actually have been doing jazz voice the entire time, but it's kind of been in the background. And I actually spent three or four consecutive years soloing with the jazz band of my former school. I did one here. I've been in a clinic this whole time doing jazz voice. So I just sing, I don't know. Notes come out and words happen at the same time, which is something I can't do on trumpet. So I thought I would put that on my senior recital. I will not be playing viola for any of those who know I play that too. I also will not be playing oboe or violin because yes, I play those too, but I don't actually study them right now. So I'm gonna do my favorite jazz solo ever. This is a transcription of Ella Fitzgerald's version of How High the Moon. I think this is actually the longest one that I know of. She does shorter ones for sure. This one's the most fun though. So I'm gonna sing this one for you. And I'm gonna have Ben coming out to turn pages for me because this is just a lot all at the same time. And adding another hand to that's just too much. Trumpeters have only so much brain space. Anyway, thank you all. I hope you enjoy this. If you didn't, at least you got to watch a movie. Take it away, speakers.
I love you, so I'm waiting. Thank you.